A Sea Dirge by Lewis Carroll. There are certain things, a spider, a ghost, the income tax, gout, an umbrella for three, that I hate, but the thing that I hate the most is the thing they call the sea. Pour salt water over the floor, ugly I'm sure you'll allow it to be. Suppose it extended for miles or more, that's very like the sea. Beat a dog till it howls outright, cruel but all very well for a spree. Suppose that he did so day and night, that would be like the sea. I had a vision of nursery maids, tens of thousands passed me by, all leading children with wooden spades, and that was by the sea. Who invented these spades of wood? Who was it cut them out of a tree? None, I think, but an idiot could, or one that loved the sea. It is pleasant and dreamy, no doubt, to float, with thoughts as boundless and souls as free. But suppose you are very unwell in the boat. How would you like the sea? There is an insect that people avoid, whence is derived the verb to flee. Where have you been by it most annoyed? In lodgings by the sea. If you like your coffee with sand for dregs, and decided hint of salt in your tea, and a fishy taste in the very eggs, by all means choose the sea. And if with these dainties to drink and eat, you prefer not a vestige of grass and tree, and a chronic state of wet in your feet, then I recommend the sea. For I have friends who dwell by the coast, pleasant friends they are to me. It is when I'm with them I wonder most that anyone likes the sea. They take me a walk, though tired and stiff, to climb the heights I madly agree, and after a tumble or so from the cliff, they kindly suggest the sea. I try the rocks and think it cool that they laugh with such excess of glee as I heavily slip into every pool that skirts the cool, cold sea.